out of 10, got you playing pretend. 9 out of 10, here we go again.
Here's what sticking to the eye kick philosophy.
My general rule of thumb, without seeing anybody kick, is that if you're just a superstar player, the star quarterback, running back, who's just doing the kicking, I always say go off the 2-inch tee because that's going to help you get a little more height. You might lose a little bit of distance, but it's going to help you with your height and it's going to help you be successful. Now, if you're the superstar soccer player that is just coming out to help the coach out, I always say go off the 1-inch tee because that's going to help you, A, get a little more height, but make you a little bit more comfortable as if you were kicking a soccer ball. So again, superstar athlete in the team, just kicking, 2-inch. If you're a superstar soccer player joining the team, use the 1-inch. And obviously, if you're the kicker and that's all you do is kick and you kick and you love it, then it depends on your ability. If you're a pretty good kicker, you might want to go to the 1-inch. If you're preparing for college, my rule of thumb is your sophomore year, you're on a 2-inch tee. Your junior year, you're off a 1-inch tee. And if you're good enough, your senior year, you want to go off the ground. But again, I say that with an asterisk. That's if you're good enough, okay? So now we'll go right into where our plant spot's supposed to be in relation to these tees, okay? So I'm going to put this tee down here, and Coach Hatlin is going to show you where his foot is supposed to be on a 2-inch tee, okay? Basically, our 2-inch tee here, you can see Coach Hatlin's foot as if you were kicking a soccer ball. So again, superstar athlete in the team, just kicking, 2-inch. If you're a superstar soccer player joining the team, use the 1-inch. And obviously, if you're the kicker and that's all you do is kick and you kick and you love it, then it depends on your ability. If you're a pretty good kicker, you might want to go to the 1-inch. If you're preparing for college, my rule of thumb is your sophomore year, you're on a 2-inch tee. Your junior year, you're off a 1-inch tee. And if you're good enough, your senior year, you want to go off the ground. But again, I say that with an asterisk, that's if you're good enough, okay? So now we'll go right into where our plant spot's supposed to be in relation to these tees, okay? So I'm going to put this tee down here, and Coach Hatlin is going to show you where his foot is supposed to be on a 2-inch tee, okay? Basically, our 2-inch tee here, you can see Coach Hatlin's foot is about the knuckle of a foot even with the ball, okay? So if there was a ball on the tee right now, his knuckle of his foot would be even with the ball, okay? Now what that does is, as Coach Hatlin shows me his knee locking out, what that does is his knees locks out right before he makes contact with the ball, and then his leg will come up, and you'll see that he's kind of catching his ball a little bit on the upstroke, barely at all, but a little bit, and that's what the 2-inch tee does. It gives you just a little bit of a cheat to get that ball in the air. Okay, now if I switch to a 1-inch tee, now Coach Hatlin's going to have to move his foot up to about the laces of his foot even with the ball. Now what that does is, as Coach Hatlin locks his leg out, it gets it a little bit closer to the ball. Just a little bit. And I'm talking barely at all, but nonetheless, it still gives you an inch worth of a cheat to catch it on the upstroke. And as he comes up and fouls through to the ball, that ball is going to take off a little bit higher for you, but you're going to have a little bit more distance than if you were using a 2-inch tee. Now, if there was no tee at all, and you're pretty good and you're looking to go to college, and you kick off the ground, then you'll see Coach Hatlin's plant spot is going to be back of his heel even with the ball. And again, now what that does is that catches impact right as his knee locks out, which is what we're going to talk about in a little bit as far as getting power. That's where you're going to get a lot of power from, but it becomes a lot harder, because now Tetlin's going to have to rely on his follow through and his upward swing to get that ball in the air. So again, he's got his toe of his foot, the big toe of his big foot, knuckle of his big foot, excuse me, lined up.
Muscle Milk helps build muscles. Zero sugar, 25 grams of protein,